بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد, we begin by mentioning Allah's name and we ask Allah to send His peace and His blessings upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Say sallallahu alayhi wasallam. يعني almost every session there are things that we know of the outcome of how people get affected. We don't know their intentions, but we think well of them. Remember what I told you, Allah said, وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ. Be good to people the way Allah was good to you, remember? And how I shared with you what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, that whenever you give, you gain more than what you gave. Last session, our wonderful sister from Iman Jasim Foundation, she held a bracelet, a golden bracelet. It was unexpected. Someone donated the bracelet. So she wanted to return the bracelet back under the condition someone would auction it, like someone would pay equivalent to it, and we can give back the lady who donated the bracelet back to her. Last session, someone did it. Multiple people did it. They gave the money, a significant amount, Allah knows best how much, and then they went their way. I end up, after my session, going to Canada. I go to one of the masajid to pray Maghrib or Isha. As I leave, a respected individual, a respected uncle, he sees me, gives me a big, nice hug. I did not recognize him because of the mask. He says, I love you for the sake of Allah. I said, I love you. May Allah love you back. Then he said a story. He said, you know, last session we were there. I'm like, you came all the way from Canada. Allahu Akbar. May Allah bless you and your family. Say ameen. So he said, a family member donated towards that bracelet. And that was maybe a week after the session. And he mentioned how that relative of his, within that week, he received a promotion in his job. This is not a random outside the plot story. This is how life works. But sometimes we may not know it for one of two reasons, usually. Either because we don't do it, let's be honest. So you're like, oh, how does it work? Because or you do it, but you're trying it. You don't test Allah. Allah doesn't get tested. You do it with certainty. Or you've done it, and Allah gave you back, but shaitan wants you to forget. Because if you remember, you will never stop. Right? Why you're sharing this? Allah will always give back. So may Allah bless our brother. This whole thing for this. May Allah bless our brother, Harun. May Allah grant him Jannah. Say ameen. He noticed Brother Isam wants an ASL interpreter. And Brother Harun, he knows how to interpret, mashallah. And he came and he's doing it. May Allah grant him Jannah. And now this is an example. May Allah purify his heart and not make it for our sake and make it for Allah's sake, Ya Rab. And may Allah bless Brother Isam, who had the ambition to learn, though he cannot hear a single word I'm saying. I'm going to keep trying. So I won't say, remember just the old lady of Bani Israel, but we think well. May Allah allow us to learn from Brother Isam as well. Right? Though he cannot hear, maybe he can feel. Let's give him a round of applause for both. Accent. Not trying to be cool, not trying to be anything, but Allah is my witness. Sometimes the greatest things that happens in these events come from you guys and not me. Very likely, and I'm being very realistic and scientific with you, very likely as you go through your life, may Allah bless you wherever you're from and wherever you will go, the one thing that you will not forget tonight is what just happened right now. That's how humanity works. Sometimes I say 1,000 words, and sometimes you do an action, not a word, that causes more impact than everything that I've done. So may Allah bless you and continue to show up to help yourself and help others. Jazakum Allah khair. May Allah bless you all. Qarun has to take action. Qarun was advised multiple times, beautiful stuff. What will he do? What will he say? His response? No. إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَى عِلْمٍ عِنْدِ. He got angry. You don't tell me how I use my money. It's not of your business to tell me what right and what wrong I should do. I worked hard to get this money. You don't know how many business decisions that were accurate that I did to get these millions. I got it from my own sweat. So don't go criticize me. You go get yourself a living, then you know how to talk. Ya Allah. إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَى عِلْمٍ عِنْدِ. And this is, remember, mind your own business. يعني خليك بنفسك. يعني عليك بنفسك. Is the most hated sentence to Allah. لا لا لا, one more time. أنت بتتكلم big words, بدك حديث, بدك proof. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وأبغض الكلام إلى الله. The most disliked of speeches to Allah is when someone tells another person, اتق الله. Have consciousness of Allah. Fear Allah. Then that person tells them, mind your own business. Mind your own business in such scenarios is so hated to Allah, he classifies it as one of the worst sentences to say. When you're being corrected and you know you're wrong, fix yourself. You can tell them, I appreciate your effort. I'll keep trying. Don't forget me in your dua. But not say, mind your own business. The guy came to you respectfully, adab. Right? Some people have to mind their own business. I'm with you. Right? You have to be understanding. But I gave you the context at which I'm referring to. May Allah protect us, Ya Rabbal Alameen. I got two scenarios for you. One guy, Ledi Library, University of Windsor. Every time we used to go to pray in the Musalla prayer area on campus, we used to pass by a group of Muslims. To the most part, they used to come and pray in congregation with us. Fantastic. There's that one brother. Every time I tell him to come pray, تعال يا أخي. He's like, you know what, bro? I don't know, bro. I need these 5 minutes. Come on, man, 5 minutes. Relax. The blessing. Never will you give except that you will gain more. Master. But he told me, don't you ever stop telling me. And I will never forget this. This was a long time ago. He said, Majid, never, ever go to prayer and pass by me except that you remind me. Maybe one day I will come. I have another example. A brother, speaking to him respectfully, I told him about Salah, and he tells me, don't you ever bring up this topic. Let me live my life the way I want. SubhanAllah, may Allah protect us. إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَى عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي. Stop saying it's, oh, God gave it to me, and God did this, and God did that. I worked hard to earn this. May Allah bless you all. Ya Rabbal Alameen. So then what happened, brothers and sisters? He ignored all of this. And Allah says, he continued his oppression. He continued his arrogance. فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ فِي زِينَتِهِ. This Qarun guy, he intentionally wore the best of clothes. That's fine. But he did it for the wrong purposes. He had the best of vehicles, used it for the wrong purposes. Just to show off, bling, bling, flash, whatever appropriate terms of today's time. Which, subhanAllah, at that time it was a rarity, right? It was a rarity. But now the majority do it. Agreed? The majority of people, they show what they have. Oh, watch what you judge my intentions. Relax. People post these things. Are you saying it's wrong? Are you saying it's right? I'm not saying wrong or I'm saying right. I'm saying watch your intentions. At times it can be great. At times it will haunt you down. So don't you post anything on social media until you go through that test. Why am I posting it? Why are you telling the world you are swimming in an infinity pool in the Maldives? إيش اللي بدك إياه? What do you want? Right? What's your purpose? I want to show the people that you can, you know, call people to Allah and still have vacations. Hadr, okay, I'll take it. Okay. Right? So now, next time I go to Maldives, I'll take a selfie, inshallah. Right? Why? I remember one time, a wonderful brother, when we were in school, he came and picked me up, I had the car that time, I picked him up for Fajr, and then he looked wide awake. So when he came to the car, I said, you look like sahi, look like you didn't sleep. He's like, yeah, I was doing Qiyamul Layl. I was doing the night prayers. And between me and myself, you know, young, overzealous, I'm like, you could have kept it to yourself, you know. You have to like, yeah, I was praying Qiyam. Yeah, I know. Bro, Akhirah. You know, you gotta focus on, keep your eyes on the prize, Brother Majid. Right? But I can't judge his intention. Maybe he said this to me so I can start waking up. So my point being is that I'm not saying don't show off what you have. I'm just telling you, watch why you show off what you have. That's all I'm asking you for. Be sincere with yourself. Why are you doing this? I don't know how much. Why are you taking a photo like this? Why? مش فاهم طب ايش حبيب خير I take a photo طب take a photo Right? Maybe he's saying remember to donate. I don't know the caption. Sometimes you have to think well of people. Right? Like someone, you know, nothing against that. It's fine. I have friends that do that. Right? Nice car rental, right? Life is tough. Tablish. Right? I love the wonderful brothers and sisters. May Allah grant you all Jannah. See what I mean? And I'm just saying what? What's my focus? Why? Leish. كل صاحب نعمة محسود. Remember the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Every blessed person has envious people towards them. Watch out. Watch who you share it maybe with mom. My mom loves to know. How was the lecture? How many people showed up? I'm like, mom, it's not. He's like, I know it's not dunya. How many people showed up? I'm like, Allahu Akbar. And what did the people say? Did they like it? I'm like, mom, it's not. Your mom likes it. Makes my mom happy. I'll tell her everything. I brag with my mom. I'm like, mom, Allah, what a muhadar, what a lecture. It was fire. Walat, right? People love me, mom, right? But to you, I probably wouldn't do that, right? So the point being is that share the good things that happen to you with those who you would not imagine will ever be envious towards you. And number one, mom and dad. Mom and dad will very likely, almost impossible, be jealous of you. So share your happy moments with them. It is so sad that you share it to the world, to the strangers, and make your profile public. And you will never go back home and tell your mom and dad what you achieved. Why would your mom and dad have to know your achievements through your friends? Isn't it sad? Wallahi, I'm telling you, as a parent, it can be very sad that I have to know about you through your friends and strangers and so on. Tell me where you applied. Tell me where you got accepted. Tell me what scholarship you received. Tell me which person you're interested to get married in. Tell me. I'm your dad. I'm your mom. I love you. I want the best for you. May Allah protect us. So this Qarun guy is just so obsessed. I want to show the world. I want to do this. I want to do that. But when he came out, bling bling, in extreme, like, you know, like he looked like stunning. Let's be realistic. It was stunning. There were two groups of people. One group of people, okay, they were so sad. He said, Ya layta lana mithla ma utiya Qarun. Look at Qarun. I wish I had like this guy. This is the life, bro. This is the life. Not waking up at 7 in the morning, go to a Ford factory. Like a mummy. Look at this life. Look at the security guards. Look at the car. Look. Hadhi al-haya. Ya layta lana mithla ma utiya Qarun. We wish we have what he has. I wish I have what he has. إِنَّهُ لَذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ He's so lucky. These are adults speaking. And adults say stuff like that, yes or no, but just different wording, different verbiage. They're so, so lucky. Oh, he's so lucky. Baba, do you know where they're going for winter break? 2 weeks, huh? They're going to Paris to ski. And we're waiting for the snow to come so we can go sledding on Ford Field. So lucky. Baba, why can't you have a house? Why can't you have a house in TPC, the golf course? Because they can't afford it. Why didn't you work harder? Why? Baba, the security by itself is $450 a month. Huh? Work. I know I have a dad. Yalla, ishtagal. I have mom at home. Mom, you go continue school too. You're so lucky. Look, you see their house? Subhanallah. Relax. Watch what you wish for. Watch what you wish for. Adult and young. Wallahi, male and female. All of us. Whether you're working or not working. Look at her house. Look, I wish I had something. I got married to this guy, miskin. Barely has an income. You want to have a house like that? Ya Allah, be ready to clean it up. That's number one. All right? Ya Allah, bismillah. Buy you 3 vacuums. Basement, first floor, third floor. Yalla, bismillah. What else? You think it's that simple? You think it's that simple? Yalla, be ready for the ayn. Be ready for it. Oh, her husband probably is like, he does money laundering. Like I'm telling you, they came here as refugees. Like, I don't know how her husband did this. You weren't ready for this? Yalla, ish. Watch what you wish for. La hasada illa fi thnatain. Two times you ever say, I wish I have what the other person has. Two times best. Number one, رَجْلٌ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْقُرْآنِ. Someone whom Allah blessed with the Qur'an, فَيَقُومُ بِهِ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ وَأَطْرَافَ النَّهَارِ. And specifically at night. Is someone who stands up and prays at night reading the Qur'an. You say, I wish I knew how to read the Qur'an and pray at night like that person. That's something you wish for, because that's something you can attain. Because that is something you can achieve. Many of us here will never own a house. Many of us here will never own $1+ million house. Many of us here will never have, you know, I don't know, security guards and that fame. Many of us here will never have more than 10,000 followers. Many of us. But many of us can go to Firdaus al-A'la. So wish for things that you can guarantee will be of benefit to you. And the other matter you can wish to have is when you see someone who is very rich. Finish, let me finish. But that person donates a lot of his wealth. You say, I wish I have money like him or her to donate like him or her. Two cases. May Allah protect us, Ya Rab. So then these people are like, I wish. So who heard this? وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمِ. The ones with knowledge, Ya Rab. May Allah make you all of them, Ya Rab. People who learned, and now you guys learned ayat. I'm very optimistic that I and you, I know grammar, it says you and I, but I'm desperate for myself more than you. I and you, that after hearing this, our view of life will be different. Khalas. I'm going to watch what I do, what kind of job I have. I'm going to be very careful. I'm going to focus on akhirah. My decisions have to be in the checkbox. How does it impact my afterlife? Not just how does it impact my neighbor. How does it impact my afterlife? That's a new checklist I will have to add. So they said, those who have knowledge, وَيْلَكُمْ يَوَيْلْكُمْ. What is this you ask for? I wish I was like him. You wish to be like this musibah, this disaster. You wish to be like Qarun, who's an oppressor. You wish to be someone who people hate. You wish to be someone who is obsessed about bragging and showing off. You're obsessed to be like someone who hates Musa. You never said, I wish to be like Musa. Allahu Akbar. You never said, I wish to be like Musa. Watch what you wish for. وَيْلَكُمْ. Then they said, ثَوَابُ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لِمَنْ آمَنَ وَعَمِنَ صَالِحًا. The reward waiting the believers is much better than all what you've seen. Fi ajr, the believers have reward. It's better than all what you see with Qarun. And na'am, with Iman, you have that richness in the heart, remember? Qarun feels empty. With all what he has, he's empty. With all the followers, he's empty. He's sad. He's lonely. You think he has all, he's miskeen. How do you know the hearts? Because Allah said so. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. Allah said, whoever goes outside my path, whoever goes astray, they will have a miserable life. I don't want to hear no one above the words of Allah. O you who is far from the deen, the further you are, I'm talking to myself. كُلْ مَا بَعِدْتْ عَنِ الدِّينِ كُلْ مَا كَنْ فِي نَكَدْ فِي الْحَيَةِ. The further you go away from the religion, the more miserable your life is. That's the equation. X مش عارف, X plus 2 equals Y. It goes like this. May Allah protect us. Ya Rabbi Al-Alameen. Something to really pay attention to. So they're saying it with confidence. Like, how do you know? La, your reward in Akhirah for the believers and dunya. Yes, dunya and Akhirah. Ya akhi, the money is with the disbelievers. The money is with the corruptors. The money is with the oppressors. Not necessarily true. Not necessarily true. You guys think, now I'm talking the people of knowledge to those who are obsessed about the dunya. You guys are saying that money being given is a sign of Allah's love. That's what they think, right? Allah gave it to him, so he must be a good guy. Allah took it away, so we must be very bad people. Why is the Muslim majority is poor? Because Allah doesn't like us. La, you guys have a whole wrong equation here. Allah giving, Allah taking does not change Allah's love and hate to us. May Allah protect us, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look at this beautiful hadith. I knew another narration, but I never knew this until today. May Allah bless you. The one that I know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, look at those below you in dunya. That's what the Prophet says. انظروا إلى من هو أسفل منكم. And instead of you driving around, I don't know, Novi, checking out houses, just why? Can you afford it? No, I just like to see these houses. It's not healthy, but anyhow. Okay, you want to go to Novi. Okay, the Prophet says, no, look at those below you. So maybe go on your way to Costco, Livonia, the trailers. May Allah bless them. May Allah guide them and grant them wealth, Ya Rab. Because why, Ya Rasulullah? He says, look at those who have lesser than you in this life. لِكَيْ لَا تَزْدَرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ. So you do not belittle the blessings Allah has given to you. When you're always around and always seeing and always watching these, pages on social media, which I advise you to be aware, yani, I'm not saying it's haram, but all what you follow, exotic cars, right? Mansions, 101, and you follow. All your timeline will make you feel poor. I'm broke, right? Why am I living this life? I'm exaggerating, but it actually hits in the mind. You have to be very careful. So your Prophet, your Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told you, look at those under you. May Allah protect us from dunya. Now the one hadith that I learned today, may Allah grant you all Jannah, so cool. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِذَا نَظَرَ أَحَدُكُمْ إِلَى مَنْ فُضِّلَ عَلَيْهِ فِي الْمَالِ وَالْخَلْقِ. If you happen to see someone who Allah gave more money than you and better looks, physical features than you, فَلْيَنْظُرْ إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ أَسْفَلَ مِنْهِ. Then look at those who have less than what you just saw. Allahu Akbar. If you felt you were shaken by what you saw of a house, of an individual, the clarity of their skin, or I don't know, whatever the case may be, their hair, the straightness of it, whatever the fashion and the, whatever is considered beautiful, and you saw it slightly hitting you like, man, go. Look at something that is less. Not just for the sake of, oh, like that. Then you go and help them out if you're able to. The one who's poor, it will not just make you feel comfortable with what you have, it will drive you to help them. Allahu Akbar. And the khayr will come to you. May Allah bless you all. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. So you guys love what the intelligent people said? I love it. May Allah make us like them. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Tayyib. Yalla, next. What happens? Qarun. What about him? Maybe he was going back home. I don't know. He's about to go have dinner. 17 type of meals. Entrees. I don't know, 3 spoons, 3 forks, 3 knives, 7 plates. Allahu ta'ala a'lam. But on his way, what happens? فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. Next ayah, so quickly, so fast, so swiftly, right when he was going back home or whatever he was going, Allah opens up the earth. فَهُوَ يَتَجَلْجَلْ فِيهَا. And he starts falling and falling and falling. It's such a scary moment. He doesn't have a parachute. He doesn't have anything like that. He's falling and falling and falling and falling and falling and falling and falling. The fear is killing him. Who is going to help you now? Go down, go down, go down, because you always thought you're above others. You always thought you're better than everyone. إِنْزَلْ تَحْتِ الْأَرْضِ. Go all the way. فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. Let's put you in your place, in your proper spot. Very severe to such people. May Allah protect us. Ya Rabbil Alameen. In a way, he was buried alive. His wealth, buried. His security guards, all those who supported him, buried. Done, vanished. What happened right there? What happened? Remember the people that said, I wish I have? You know what they said? Ya Allah, Ya Allah. They said, وَيْكَأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ وَيَقْدِرُ. Oh, it's so clear to us. If Allah really loved him, he would have never done that to him. Allah gives and takes, does not reflect Allah's love to you. If you're someone who is trying so hard to make so much money, but it's genuinely not working, doesn't mean Allah doesn't love you. It means Allah loves you. Some people getting so much money gets into their heads. And out of love to you, Allah protects you from it. I'm not saying don't pursue. Pursue within reason. May Allah grant you all wisdom, Ya Rabbil Alameen, and myself. But go, but be very careful, Ya Allah. When Allah gives people children and others not, doesn't mean necessarily they committed a sin and you don't deserve it. When someone tries to apply for the U.S. citizenship, tries to bring their spouse from overseas, things didn't work out, Allah loves you. It's tough. I know. I feel you. But don't take it that Allah hates you. Stop saying Allah hates me. Allah doesn't want the best for me. La, Allah loves the believers. Allah yuhibbul muttaqeen. May Allah make us of them. Ya Rabbil Alameen. And you know what they said? And I want you to pay close attention. Close attention. They said, لَوْلَا أَمَّنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا لَخَسَفَ بِنَا. La, 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 la. Had the موضوع huge. Because I spoke about Qarun, you're like, you know what, I don't have that kind of money, so I think I'm safe. No, you have other blessings too, you have to watch out from. But what they said here, the people that don't have that many followers, the people that don't have that kind of money, the people that don't have that kind of status and power, they said, if it wasn't for God's blessings, we would have been swallowed by earth as well. Why? Did they do it? Did they do what Qarun did? No. So why are they saying, alhamdulillah, and we deserve to be swallowed by earth? We deserve, like, what just happened to Qarun, being buried alive, we deserve it. But Allah saved us. Allahumma lakal hamd. How do you deserve it? Because if you wish, and this can fall to all of us here, if you wish to do something that is bad, something that is evil, you saw someone doing it, well off, rich, famous, whatever, and you're like, man, I would love to do what he did. I would love to do what she did. And the only reason you did not do it is because you couldn't. You'll be punished just like them. Intabih, this is a warning. If you saw someone donating $100,000 and you're like, man, if I had that kind of money, I would have donated it. Would Allah reward you as if you donated? But why this? Okay, I like it. Right? Yes, I know another hadith. What is it? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever is about to do something wrong, a sin, and steps back from it, Allah rewards and gives them good deeds. Yeah. These people did not do it. In another hadith, min jarrai, means because of Allah's sake. The guy's about to rob a bank. Okay, he's about to rob a bank. Got everything ready, the mask, all that stuff. Not COVID mask, to cover himself, whatever, right? All this stuff. And then he's like, man, this is wrong. This is wrong. Forget it. Allah will reward them because they felt it's wrong. Hada ghalat. But the guy's like, bro, I'm going to rob this thing. Bismillah. Bismillah. Right? Okay? So maybe he said, Bismillah, he felt bad. Allah probably rewarded him. Okay? He's like, I'm going to go rob this bank. Let's go, go. Oh, they turned on the lights. Go, go. They turned on the lights. Go. You have the robbing of the bank with zero cash. May Allah protect us. So intabihu what you wish for. That's why they said, now they gained the knowledge. So now they learned. May Allah enlighten us the way He enlightened these people. They're enlightened. وَيْكَأَنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ. The disbelievers are never successful. We got it. Then Allah ends. The final lesson. Ultimate success belongs to the righteous. Allah says, تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًّا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah says, the Akhirah, Jannah, may Allah make us all of the people, Ya Rab of Jannah, Ya Rab. It is for those who have no two qualities. They don't have these two qualities. عُلُوًّا فِي الْأَرْضِ. There are people that do not focus to be on the top in the sense to get people, you know, praises. Their focus is to be appreciated by the people. Their focus is to be recognized. They're not obsessed about recognition. That's one. They're not show-offs. Number two, wala fasada. They don't seek to spread corruption. They don't seek to justify it, legalize it. Whatever the case may be, they stand against corruption. Two main traits, and at the end of the day, وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Beautiful lesson. Great reflection for all of us to learn from, especially this part of the world. Especially this part of the world, because we are some of the most blessed people on earth. Agreed? Say Alhamdulillah. So show the blessings that Allah has given you in a way that pleases Allah. طيب. Then, Allah knows exactly when this happened, the story of Qarun, but there's something coming up. Musa alayhi salam. What about him? Musa alayhi salam, Allah appoints a second meeting with him. Second meeting? Whoa. I know the first meeting with Allah, remember the mountain of Futur? What was the first meeting about? To deal with Fir'aun, right? Allah met Musa one-on-one. He told him what to do. Meet with Pharaoh. Pharaoh drowned. What's the second meeting for? Second meeting is so serious. Allahu Akbar. Fir'aun, serious. That Allah tells Musa, I want you to train yourself for this meeting for 40 days of worship. 40 yom. Why? There's a big, big mission. Bigger than Fir'aun. I need 40 days? Huge. What's the mission? What's the next meeting? What's the next phase of Musa alayhi salam's life? It will be our next year's series, inshallah. Next year in January, inshallah. 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 Inshallah.